Hey everyone, welcome back to Playcrastination Population 286. Today we're back playing some more of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus, and for the first time in several days, I feel somewhat good, which there's no way this desk is actually made of wood. I got it for $35 at Walmart. Is this? Oh, I got this dresser for $35 at Target. Okay, so neither of these are probably real wood, but hopefully hopefully I stay feeling better. What are we gonna do to celebrate me feeling a little better? I'm feeling the Loster Keeper. Let's get a coin out here. Let's get a nice quarter. Oh God. You know, the first day you're feeling better, you should do something that makes you feel awful. So if I get heads, we're gonna play as the Lost and go for the Void. If I get tails, we'll do the Keeper. And that is a tails, great, cool. Awesome, we're gonna do a Keeper hard mode run and try to beat the Void today. 2MF3B4K8. For those of you guys who don't know, I'm trying to adjust this microphone. For those of you guys who don't know what the Keeper is, who he is, what he do, what he is, basically, the Lost used to be the hardest character in the game. And then they said, you know what, we're going to give the Lost some good old, yeah, it's unfortunate, no small rock. We're going to give the Lost Holy Mantle, which suddenly made him, like, not only a playable character, but, like, a decently winnable character. Store key allows us to go to shops for free, which I do value. The gimmick here with the Keeper, if you've never seen him before, you'll notice up there he has coin health. So basically, instead of picking up red hearts, he can only get coin tiers. HP does not exist, kind of like it did on the ultra hard run. Luckily, he does come with a space bar item that once per room, we can crack on it and try to make some HP appear. We have a 50-50 shot of having a coin appear in the room, and there are sometimes a nickel. But yeah, that's the gimmick, basically. What makes that hard? Like, oh, you can just stack up a bunch of HP and just have... Oh, damage upgrade is pretty valuable. You can just stack up a bunch of HP and get a bunch of coin tiers and get a bunch of coin HP and you're the greatest. You know, in theory, you could. But in practice, you can actually only have -2 luck with the Keeper, eh? That's how you make him extra hard, I get it. In reality, with the Keeper, you can actually only hold 2 spirit heart, or 2... coin slots, like two coin, not like on a vending machine, like on a slot machine. You can only have 2 HP containers essentially at any given time. You can never have more than that. Now there are ways around it, sort of. 9 lives, of course. Hopefully it's not an XL floor because I already took red heart damage. I don't think it was though. But yeah, so essentially, even if you get HP upgrades, if you're at 2 HP already, you can't take them, which means a lot of things. Firstly, for deals with the devil are essentially useless, because even if, you just can't, nope, that's not what I thought it was. Well, you know what, well, we'll take it anyway, because we do have a second trinket, but I definitely, for a second in my brain, thought that was Fanny Pack, which is good. The best item that you can pick up with the... there's several items that help make this pretty good. Make the Keeper better, I should say. I would never dare call him good. Basically, you're looking for items that help you generate coins in a room. Because the most hits you can take in a room is 2. After 2 hits, you're done. Unless you have Holy Mantle, then you can take a third, but like still. Items like Piggy Bank. Fanny Pack, anything that could drop a coin. Swallowed Penny is a fantastic trinket, which means we should be blowing up more pots than I currently am. You should also just press spacebar as soon as you get in a room, just to have that coin on the ground. But yeah, so another unfortunate thing about this guy, obviously with the lack of being able to pick up hearts or spirit hearts, as you saw when we cracked open that tinted rock earlier, only flies came out. All HP is replaced with flies, basically. Which is... means no spirit heart protection. Pills, this is also very unfortunate. I'm gonna do it, but if any of them are a health... Oh, great. Fantastic. Retro vision. If any of these are a health downgrade, that's really bad. That's really bad. If any of them are a health downgrade, we pretty much lose, because we'll only get 1 HP. But I'm just gonna go down to the next floor. And obviously, no spirit hearts equals no deal with the devil protection. Let's just, like, be honest with ourselves so that we don't, like... I don't want to give you guys a false sense of security or anything. We're probably going to lose maybe several times with the Keeper in this run. Again, true professionals would leave all of the coins on the ground so that you could go picking them up at a later date. I'm not a true professional. I'm not even a false professional. Looking for tinted rocks, not seeing any. Small Rock is, of course, a fantastic pickup. Nine Lives is wonderful. Any respawn, really. Except you want to stay the Keeper, so maybe not any respawn. Who are we fighting? We're fighting a Fistula on a bit of a small playing field. It's okay. Our tier stat is god-awful, you are noticing. Okay. Yeah, this is not good. There goes the deal with the Devil Chance, so that is unfortunate for sure. I would like to pick up our HP. Okay, there's just too much on the screen and not quite enough dodging room for me to actively maintain here. Oh, yay, yay, yay. But we made it work. We survived. We lost our deal with the devil because of this awful room. But you know what? That's okay. HP is completely useless. We'll take it and we'll go. This is looking like not as successful. You can pretty much see from right off the bat whether it's going to be a successful keeper run or a non-successful keeper run. And just being honest with ourselves and being honest with you, this is looking pretty much like your stereotypical I'm effed, basically. Not really, though. Non-successful keeper run. We'll keep trying. Maybe we'll get something fantastic in our item room, like the poop. But it's pretty much looking like this one's going to be a let's just not talk about it. In fact, I'm just going to go down to the next floor. I don't even think exploring is worth our time. So far, we've gotten nothing, but we got a damage upgrade in our first room, but a pretty small one. Only brought us up to 4.2 from 3.5, so not a huge one. And actually, I don't even think it did that. I think it just does every other tier, so it doesn't actually affect your damage stat. And we've gotten a tiers downgrade, so pretty much your classic recipe for disaster of nothing going well so far. But again, if it wasn't my first day feeling better, I still have like a little bit of a nose issue, you can probably smell. The fact that it's the size of the moon, hi-yo! But, magic mushroom would be cool. Liberty cap would also be cool. I think I'll take that over whipworm. We get 5 cents in here, sure. How do you do? And, we'll look for our shop now. Again, if we can find piggy bank in the shop, swallowed penny from a pot, these are all things that would be good. That is also something that would probably be good, but I'd like to... Oh, this is unfortunate. I'd like to get other things done first. Other things done first. Are you Soul Man? I don't know if he was Soul Man, but he's a Soul Man. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Again, I should be using this once per room, just because we can at least be getting, like, I pretty much only use it if I get hit, which is not the correct usage of it. You should be using it every room no matter what, just because you can still get money from it. And with Store Key, you can visit shops for free, so it just makes sense to try to get as much money as possible, because what if I go and we have freaking, the item that I'm looking for, the item that I mentioned prior, piggy bank, and we can't afford it because I don't have enough money. That would be unfortunate. We would hate ourselves. All right, give me an item better than the poop. Better than the poop. Disnemoration. Forever alone. I will get those wrong perpetually, so don't expect anything else. All right, we were teleported right to our boss fight, which is fine because we want the best chance possible of getting a deal with the devil. Give me something easy like a husk fight. Like a husk fight. I could do a husk fight. Please, though. We have our best chance right now, so might as well go in. The nickels are a little out of control. And let's get this going. We have the hollow. Literally easier than the fight that I wanted, so thank you very much. Get him in there with a little bit of attack flight damage. We're going to get our deal with the devil here. Nine lives. Nine lives. Nine lives is the only thing that makes our lives worth it. The damage upgrade is nice. And the zipper. Just kidding, it's a razor blade, but it looks just like a zipper, so I will always call it that. Zipper's useless, and we will not take it, so maybe we'll get a deal with the angel run going from here on out. I don't know. I'd be fine with it. Deal with the angel, honestly, better, because we can't really afford to be giving away. We really need a tiers upgrade. We can't afford to be giving away our HP anyway. Okay, let's find the item room. By item room, I mean shop. Let's find that bad boy and see what we can do within it and see if maybe the illustrious piggy bank is there. Hey, if you're playing the seed, let me know if piggy bank was on the last floor, because I want to know if my recklessness, despite all my rage, I'm still just a rat in a cage. I want to know if my recklessness and leaving the floor too quickly ended up causing me any sort of grief. So just let me know that in the comments below, you know. Attack me. We've been teleported. No need for that to happen. Go up here. All right, we've been teleported. No need for that to happen. Cool. All right, this room is pretty much useless and makes me very upset. About everything. The amount of things spawning in this room makes me upset about everything. The amount of things spawning in this room makes me upset. Okay, that run was doomed from the start anyway, so you know what? We'll do it again. 09SXHMZH again. That run was doomed from the start. We didn't have the... We missed our first deal with the devil, which I consider pretty essential. Small rock, please. Okay. It's actually a pretty decent payout, considering... The voids are really annoying me. Like, I'm glad they're fixed somewhat, so that they don't spawn infinitely anymore. But the fact that they still spawn infinitely is, like, real obnoxious. Especially when we have the tier stat of a... Something that never cries? A child using... What's the name of that... freaking shampoo that looks like, I should not have used that. What's the name of that shampoo? GB Bug. What's the name of that shampoo that looks like a fish with the no tears? Jergens or something? Gersons? Germans? German shampoo? Yep. German shampoo. You never cry. All right, let's go. And let's try to do a little bit better on this run. First four doesn't really matter if we take damage, of course. I also, you know, I'm like considering like, you know, I could just hold, that's nice. Keep teleporting your own bombs, my friend. I could just hold R until we have a decent run, and honestly, probably should. The Keeper especially is one of those characters that's just like, you can pretty much tell pretty quickly if you're going to have a run that's going to be worthy of making, especially the Hush. Like, first of all, it's hard enough to make it to the Hush, and then this time it's like, hey, make it to the Hush, also you have the hardest character in the game. So, you pretty much have to have a run that's just worthy, and you know, range and shot speed, that's pretty much exactly what we're looking for, and a black heart that we can't use. Heyo! Pretty much excited. Having double charges, actually pretty good, so let's try to get to 7 cents. Being able to get to a double charge, basically, I mean... Allow me to say something kind of crazy. Having double charges doubles our chances that we get a payout in a room, which is especially good in things like boss fights, and it's going to be really helpful in the Hush fight. I also wonder if doing the Hush fight is even worth it, or if it's actually smarter to just go regular path and just hope for a teleporter to pop up. You know, I should use this. Okay, well... Good to know. If you were the secret room, where would you be? Maybe below me, maybe above me? There's actually a couple possibilities, which I don't like. And we get no, I mean, again, -2 luck stat because they just don't want you to have good things. I don't think a secret room can be here. I've been proven wrong. And we get Rune Bag. Rune Bag, pretty good. I like it as an item. I'll take it. I wonder if they put the -2 luck on there just to make sure that wooden nickel doesn't pay out as much. Although I think it's a 50-50 shot every time. I'm not sure though. We'll go for some luck upgrades. That would also explain why we're getting no pennies or anything from any of these. Also can't visit curse rooms at the, Also can't visit curse rooms as the keeper. So that's another like, that's another thing where it's just like, you know, life isn't very good. I'm just a kid and life is a nightmare. Let's keep going. Stop wasting time here. Dilly dallying. Battery charge. Could be useful. Again, most of my runs in the past where I've played as the keeper, I've found that the easiest way to lose is to get rid of the wooden nickel. When you're using it, you're like, ah, oh, it's just 50-50 shot of getting a penny. That's not that valuable. It becomes extremely valuable as you're traversing the floors and, ay. Got a little scared there. Almost stepped on the speaks, but didn't do it. Let's get some shots in here. Get some damage going. Yeah, we have so much damage. So much damage, I don't even know what to do with it. That guy's scared. He should be, because I'm coming for him. Nice. That's good. That's good. Remember, deal with the devil chance. Preserve it. Deal with the devil. And even if you don't preserve, like, even if you don't want anything with the deal with the devil, at least you're increasing your chances of, you're earlying your chances. I don't know if that makes any sense. It probably does not. Blank rune. You're making it more likely. Oh, God. A fast mullaboom. Seems vastly unnecessary. You're just increasing the chance that you get deal with the angels even earlier, which is good. You want to get them as quickly as possible. Because, you know, you never know when Godhead could save your run, basically, is what it boils down to. Okay, didn't even see that shooting fly in there, so could have taken damage there, but we didn't. Boss fight here, I think I want to... It's a hard choice, but I think I want to... visit item room first. I also think that I want to blow this up and maybe get small rock. Oh, we get a golden chest. We should save our key for our boss fight, though. We should save the key, I mean, for the item room. Again, I'm just talking nonsensically. I see that mimic. can't do anything about it, unfortunately, so it's just going to stay there. For some reason, I thought we were GB Bug for a second. And honestly, my mind has never been flooded quite this badly. We have two blank runes, so if we don't like our item we have in this room right here, which I don't, we could go for the Purthro. We got an Ansu's, and we duplicated it. And then we get an Alges, which would have been great on the boss fight. And then we can try one more time and try to Purthro. Hagalaz, I think? Yeah. Gemini. Gemini is a little bit of extra damage early, but I wonder if we can like activate these spikes from here. Hello. Nope. Cannot. Gemini is a little bit of damage early, but it really doesn't scale that well into the game. What in the world is this? Compost. Gain more friends. It's just like a box of spiders? That only gives one spider instead of multiple? I don't know. 7-cent magic fingers. Fanny pack is that item, one of the items that I mentioned earlier that we'd really like to have, but I don't see 15 cents in our future, so instead, we're gonna go fight our boss. Oh, no, but... Cool. Pin fight, at least, which means we would have had a guaranteed deal with the devil. But instead, I goofed it. You saw it here first, folks. I panicked. I got stuck in the doorway trying to exit so I could reset the room, and I got hit by spikes. Give me that 36% deal with the devil chance. It did. It did, and I am so appreciative, as long as it's not Krampus. It's the freaking zipper again! Take old bandage just because it's an item. Maybe if we reroll in the future, we could reroll it into something better. But, yeah. Not super thrilled about seeing the zipper once more. Maybe we can never see it again. That'd be cool. Again, I know it's not the zipper, but it looks like a zipper. So give me some credit. Also, I broke my pants yesterday speaking of zipper. Apparently, like, I keep getting, like, a lot of signs. Believe me, there's plenty in front of me that I should probably, like, maybe start working out. Maybe go to the gym every now and again. Maybe not be such a disgusting piece of garbage. What do we got here? AWAS. Pop it, see if we can get a crawl space. No crawl space, just a teleportation down to the next floor. Which we don't really want. We would like a battery charge, though. By battery charge. Actually, I would like a battery charge because I'd like to have a coin for this room. But we made it through. Get a bomb. Get a bomb up in here. Nope, just some money. I'll come back. I believe Small Rock is in that rock. I know he can be. Small Rock is also, like, it's one of the quickest ways that you can take this run from zero to something. Also, you may have noticed we've gotten, like, garbage items over the past couple. Please, you have to get rid of something on this room just because the shots fill up too much of the screen. There you go. Stand at a weird angle on this guy. There you go. As long as you can, like, take a little bit of control of this room, I would like to keep our deal with the devil chance as high as humanly possible. Gemini, if you want to get in there, yeah, you can just keep doing your thing there. Yeah, he's gonna try to shoot, and this one's at a perfect angle to basically make our lives hell, but Gemini's gonna get in there and do some stuff. Key is good. That's distant admiration. Finally, for once, I can get it right. Gotcha. Don't panic. That's an easy room. Also should have pressed this before. The voids, again, just need to stop. We're done with you. We want nothing to do with you. You're off the team, is what I'm trying to say to you. No, Gemini, do not blow him up when I'm next to him. That is my one rule. And tonight, you're gonna break your one rule. Really, though? Really? You want to be a joker? Tis the season for the keeper. Terrible items every peeper. Nothing rhymes with keeper except for peeper. But I can't use that in a sentence. Da da da. Okay. Let's cut it out. 15 cents, we can check out our shop here. Free Diploplia. You know what? It's a toughie. It's a toughie but a goodie, as they say. We could take Diploplia, and then if we get our deal with the devil chance, which is only a 30% chance, first of all. Am I going to try it here? I think I'm going to try it here. So I'm basically hoping we don't take two hits on this boss fight. I hope we don't take any hits on the boss fight, obviously. What I can do is I can Diploplia. If we get a deal with the devil, I can Diploplia the items and take them for free. We get a Stain Fight, which is no biggie. Stain Fight is no biggie. Just don't take stupid damage. GB Bug, if you want to keep paying out. I would like to get in a place where I feel like I can dodge a little bit better, which is right here. Okay. Okay, that's nothing. Gemini, again, you want to get in there? You are more than welcome to. That is your right. And nobody can take it away from you, please, though. Okay. We're good. Halfway done. Because I'm halfway there, and I'm on my way, and I'm feeling the stain. Because, you know, hey, keep doing that attack. I love that attack. One more. Ah, just a couple more. There you go. One more. Yes. Deal with the devil. Yeah, it's a pentagram. Question. I'm about to look something up. Ignore me. Just keep watching the game. I'm going to look at the pentagram and see if it's a damage multiplier or a damage upgrade. Isaac, pentagram. If it's an upgrade, if it's a plus, we could double it and gain double the plus. It is plus one damage, so we could essentially gain plus two damage instead. And it also increases the chance of devil and angel deals. So I wonder if that stacks as well. So I think we're going to use Diploplia here. Maybe not the greatest use of all time, I understand, but plus, that's like a lot of extra damage, and I'm pretty good with that. Perthrow also would have been cool, and we have two Perthrow runes now to Perthrow Isaac's heart into something good. All right, you see what I'm seeing? Do you see what I see? A chance to win is the key. I don't know, feeling musical. Also feeling a little snotty, but that's a little more gross. Perthrow this thing, Virgo. The invincibility could be great. We could make invincibility great again. I understand this. But also, do we really think there's a chance? Also, do we really think there's a chance that I actually make the Hush fight? Let's be honest. At 10 minutes through Caves 1, I don't think so. I think we just have to try and play methodically and try to basically craft the best run possible. We could really still use a Tears upgrade. Gemini. I insulted that man earlier, but he is playing well. Okay, anything? No drops. Looking for bombs because there still is. We still have a Tinted Rock back there that could, keyword could, and other keyword probably won't, but still could contain Small Rock, which also would have been a great item to Diploplia, but I like our doubling of this bomb, please. Oh, infinite bomb, please. Magic Mush, please. Again. I think I can't take pills, so just ignore that. But I think we have to play and like literally place a bomb by every single mushroom in the hopes of getting Magic Mushroom. Again, the pills are cool, but if there's a single health downgrade, it's over. Like, we basically cannot take a single hit, and that's just not somewhere I feel comfortable. Okay, I've tried this before. You may, I know what you're thinking. Shoot the angel statue, you'll get the key piece. It'll increase angel chances. It actually doesn't give key piece, which is dumb, but it doesn't, so I have to accept that fact. Open this, see what we got in here. 10 cents, plus another bomb. We can also now visit our secret room, see what's brewing in here. Magic Mushroom's brewing in here, not yet. I'll even take Mini Mush. I just want some stats. I'm a stat man. All right, and you're a scat man. Cool. Perthrow rune. Do we Perthrow Virgo or do we take it? Perthrow it. Get dead bird. Which is also basically useless, but we'll pick it up anyway. Dead bird, protective buddy. And now let's go see if Small Rock was in the rock where I believed it was. We have so many mushrooms on this floor. I refuse to believe that Magic Mush is not among them. I refuse it. All right, I've been refused myself. Are there any more rooms with mushrooms? I don't think so. I think that was probably it. Small Rock here would be delectable. All right, we got some Spirit Arts instead, hence why you saw those flies. More mushrooms. Again, I will do anything possible. While we have infinite bombs on this floor, it's literally just, and now that I've given up, oh. This was a bit of a shocker to me. And maybe we would have been better off. Well, speed down. Why don't you? I know what you're saying. We probably would have been better off there rerolling Bob's Rotten Head and taking Virgo. Yeah, but I didn't know at the time. I will take Distant Admiration because if we happen to get... if we happen to get Unbreakable, it's an orbital. And We have Gemini plus that. We could technically kill any boss just by standing there. And since we're not doing Hush Fight anyway, we're not really worrying about the speed of the run. We're basically praying that a Void shows up. A Yara rune. You're too kind. Do we want Liberty Cap over Store Key? Nah, I still value Store Key for its ability to give us what we need. We're still looking for small Mom's Trinket Box, another item in the shop that is fantastic because you can use that and give yourself a pretty good chance of getting small... Swallowed Penny. And while you're holding Mom's Trinket Box, you actually get double the effects of Swallowed Penny. So you'd actually get two payouts every time you got hit instead of one. So pretty well worth it there. This run definitely better off than the last one was. I mean, we have like double the damage of the last one, literally. But still, none of this matters, if we're being honest. So close no matter how far. Nothing really matters with the Keeper. Because you find one bad room that just like sends you for hurting. And all of a sudden, you're toast. Okay. Interesting room. I think I'd like to blow up everything. Okay. Got some HP. Got some supplies, basically. And from here, we get a pill that we will not use. Would like to access those, but I don't have the ability to fly, so I will not be. I will go into our secret room, though. Please die. We're actually doing a pretty decent amount of damage from all of our different avenues here. I would like to kill... this fly in the center of the room, like right there, like by the mushroom if we could, but we didn't, and that's okay. I just wanted to, just to save a bomb, you know, and try to still get that magic mushroom, but I'm sure we'll get it at some point. If we're this diligent, the game has to reward us at some point, I would think and I would hope. Oh man, it's just been such a long time since I've played as the Keeper. I'm so used to playing as characters where you can just get overly, insanely powerful and just like basically wreck the game. This one, you really can't do that. Another item that's really good is Penny Tears. If you can get Head of the Keeper and sometimes your tears occasionally spawn pennies, that's fantastic. Okay, Golden Poop is also pretty good. A bomb is, you know, paid for us to get in here. Counterfeit Penny doesn't really help us too much. This was a waste of a bomb because we could have came into our shop for free with Store Key, but I used it, so it's okay. The Greed fight is no fun because his shot speed is out of this world, but as long as we do it carefully. Oh, I finally figured out what, I was like, what the heck? Remember, you know, I've been like complaining for like 100 years about the game going really speedy sometimes? Oh my gosh, he hit it with a shot speed. That's funny. Sometimes the game seems like it's sped up. I'm so stupid. There's a new pill in the game called I'm Excited, which just like increases the speed of enemies for the floor or for a couple rooms. I don't know exactly how it works, but in greed mode, it works like literally forever. 2 Yara runes. So if we find something that's worth doubling, not the Irish place, but you know, come in here. Ooh, we get large zit. This is our first time seeing this item because it's kind of gross. What does it do? Creep, did it say creep shots? I'm not seeing any creep. So who knows? Our luck stat is so low, it's probably, maybe it's like, oh, there's one. That's really gross. That's very yucky. I'll be honest with you. I'm a little uncomfortable with the yuckiness. Let's see what we got in here. Pretty much useless. We got some flies. Let's go get our 75% deal with the devil chance. That has to be doubly increased. Doubly. And we have a 50% angel chance. I think if we donate money to our shop, we can actually increase that angel chance. And I think that's what we want to do. Oh my god, this is the stupid room. I have called this room stupid so many times. I am well documented in my hatred of this room, but we didn't take a hit on it. This room is so stupid. But you know what? You just have to be as fantastically awesome as me. Hagalaz. We can also double everything that's... Oh, wait, there's greed. Hagalaz, sure. Magic mushroom. No dice. Still preserve that deal with the devil chance. No tinted rocks in here that I can see. So we're going to fight the hollow. The wretched. Another pretty easy boss fight if we're being honest with ourselves. There you go. Gemini cutting him up. There we go. Don't take a hit there. 75% chance. Why would it? Hi, my name's Probability. And... I mean nothing. Okay. But at least we have a guaranteed deal with the double chance on this floor. as long as we don't take damage. I should not have used that. We're getting... Rune Bag is actually pretty nice. We're getting at least one Ansu's rune per floor, which is helping us just, like, get our bearings and figure out our way very quickly. Okay, I do not want this. I also don't like the... No. That was a little too close for comfort. Also, I don't like that you turn into a mushroom. Okay. Nothing in here yet. Looking for item room. There's the item room. Really, though? Why? Is that completely 100% necessary? Please, Penny, thank you so much. And there goes our deal with the double chance down to 16. And there's a useless space sprite that we can't even use. Technically, with the double pentagram payouts, though, as long as we don't take damage on the boss fight, it's still a 50-50 shot, even if taking damage on the floor, of getting a deal with the devil, which is really nice. Diplopia pentagram is going to have to be something I think about a little bit more often, because that's pretty nice. Definitely more valuable than store key. This, essentially, as long as we have bombs, and as long as rooms have... as long as we have bombs and rooms have rocks, we have like near infinite HP, which is fantastic. Now, important fights like the void fight, the delirium fight, I should say, don't have bombs or don't have rocks. I get that. But in the journey to get there, at least we now have maybe a little bit more of a chance. So yes, that was a little gross. You're saying there's a chance. Okay. Yeah. I feel okay. I still don't feel great about this run. My 28 tier stat is making me feel a little bad. The best pickup I've found, like what I think has correlated to almost every time I pick up this item, I win with the Keeper. Ansu's, thank you. Is actually surprisingly okay, we got some flies. Is actually, and maybe surprisingly, we have like Curse of the Giant or something. What is this garbage? Is a skinny odd mushroom. Skinny odd mushroom is such an increased tier stat, especially when you have triple shot. It makes you fire like, it's like it's a damage downgrade, don't get me wrong, but you fire a lot quicker. Again, these big rooms can basically sod off. I said, didn't mean to pick that up because that was my only HP for the room, but I think we're fine. Keep your distance, maintain distance. Get him. Got it. Okay, big room again. We have about 1,000 of these for some reason. Don't know why the game has predetermined that that's the way that this is going to go, but it has. Oh, too many. Too many of these things for me to feel comfortable. Okay, Gemini, you're going to come in clutch here. Thank you, Gemini. Keep it going. Keep the clutchness happening. Oh, it's like a car with a stick shift. I think they call it a clutch, don't they? I don't know. I'm not a car person. I wish I was. Oh, God. And we have one more enemy flying around the room, walking around the Christmas tree. Golden key doesn't really help us, but maybe if we find some golden chests, maybe if we find some Michelob Golden Ultra. That's a beer, right? I'm cool, guys. Okay, let's check out shop. Hopefully no super greed, because I'm not feeling very super greedy. There's options pretty good. At least gives us a chance to maybe make what our mama gave us. Thank you. That man is small now. Okay. Yeah, gotta use Algus because it's especially in this fight, which now spawns. Fantastic, by the way. My favorite. I love that he now spawns. Get that orbital in there. Get the orbital in there. Thank goodness for the orbital. Thank goodness for the Algus rune. Just gotta love 50-50 shot. 50-50 shot. Come on. Give me Angel. It's not terrible. But these two items you've given me are absolute garbage. Take the Guardian Angel. These two items are so bad. Gotta go for the trinket and hope it's Swallowed Penny. It's Rib of Greed. I just don't get how the items can all be so bad, but it's okay. We're gonna overcome. The only damage upgrade we've gotten is the pentagram, and everything else has been speed, a little bit of range, maybe some useless HP upgrades. Can't go in there, so what am I doing? Okay. I mean, we could go in there, but it's honestly, it basically gives us a 50-50 shot of living. So that's not something, unless you have a guaranteed way to live, that's not something you want to do. Small rock would be great. You've kind of ducked me over thus far, so why would you change now? 37.5% deal with the devil chance. It's not bad. It's not bad, but if we take a hit, it's going to go way down. And of course, we have no HP now. Okay, but again, like I said, what's nice about this is Temperance card. Blow that up and get no pennies back from it. But we can always just do this and get pennies back from this, and there's our HP. Boom. See you later, sucker. And I will leave some on the ground this time to go back and pick up from time to time, because I think it could, unfortunately, with the way this run's going, might end up being quite valuable. Obviously, the hope is that it doesn't, though. Obviously, the hope is that we just get really powerful pretty darn soon, because right now, I'm not really feeling it. We're doing a lot of damage. We're just, the problem with the Keeper is I'm doing a lot of damage is not a win. It's not enough for a win condition. You have to be doing crazy damage or be doing good damage and have infinite. I really want a Jin reroll me, baby. You either have to be doing crazy damage so that you one-shot everything, or have pretty good damage but be really defensible. And right now, we're lacking a little bit on the defensive part. We do have, like, we do have an orbital to block shots now in Guardian Angel, but still. Okay, no Super Greed. Double effectiveness, I think, is really good. Also, Nun's Habit, so that if we get hit, we can use it again. Okay, I'm starting to see a possibility here. I'm starting to see. He's beginning to believe. I'm starting to see how we can do this. So basically now, every time we use this, we have a 50-50. That would be the odds of both paying out. The odds of at least one paying out, I believe, would be 75%. If I'm remembering how to do statistics. It would be like the odds that... It would be the odds that... One pays out is 50 plus 50, minus the odds that... Either neither payout per throw is, I'm going to take it. Yeah, it would be, so the odds that either one pays out is 50. The odds that the other pays out is 50, that would be 100. But you also have to account for the fact that both could pay out or neither could pay out. In which case, those are both 50 times 50, which is 0.25. So that does not make any sense. But you know what? I don't know how to do math. I'm going to die. No, I need to pick that up. Lost my deal with the double chance, but I think we lost that a long time ago. Wafer. It doesn't help us, does it? There's no such thing. Yeah. Unfortunately, doesn't do anything for us. Charm of the Vampire also does nothing for us. The wafer, I'm pretty sure, like, there are no half coin intervals in with this character. It's just not a thing. So there are no half coin intervals. Therefore, there's no way to only take half damage. So I think the wafer is just useless, which is sad, but that's the reality we live in. If this is Perthro, I'm going to be upset. Augiz, I think we need to just stack these up. If we can, like, because we can survive, it seems, on a room-to-room basis. We just need to stack as many of these Augiz runes. The air rune, unfortunately, just not that valuable to me. But Augiz runes could be make or break. There's nothing in this room which has me uncomfortable. Okay. Come in here, pop this. We got a double payout, which is fantastic. Okay, watch out for the foot, watch out for the foot. Again, we have an orbital. Get in there and do some damage with the orbital if you can. Don't risk, like, don't go ham if you don't have to. Leave the coins on the ground. Okay, it's okay. She hit us. We lost our deal with the double chance pretty much completely. We have a 4% chance still, but that's pretty dang small. And so maybe we can still make it work, but probably not. You finish the fight. You finish the fight. You take the fact that you're alive and you love it. Are we going to make it to the hush fight? No. So we're pretty much banking, like I said, on the fact that we get a void to appear. And again, that's more statistics that I just haven't memorized yet and that I just don't know very well. The HP upgrade could be good because if we get a deal with the devil, we could come back and pick up the HP upgrade. We don't get one, though, so it doesn't actually matter. Also, no more shops for the rest of the game, so the rooms are also going to be harder for the rest of the game. So we really have to be vigilant. We really have to be vigilant. We have to be on our toes. Ansu's rune is so good. The more of the floor that we can see as quickly as possible, the better. And it looks like we have quite a ways to go for our boss fight. So buckle up. Let's hope for some good play in some of these rooms. Hagalaz means a bunch of money. Oh, he was small and I didn't see him. That was terrifying. But a lot of money, fortunately, means a lot. There you go. He's about to lap him. Dale Earnhardt Jr. over here. He did lap him. That's insane. I didn't know they could do that. There we go. Get rid of him. Get rid of him. Get rid of him. We have a lot of money on the ground to heal ourselves with, which is good. Keep the Alga's room, because if things get actually dastardly and sinister and terrifying, like, this room's not great, but if things get, like, really terrifying, then we can deal with it that way. Gotta get rid of the voids. Gotta get rid of the voids. Gotta get rid of the voids. I'm not doing enough damage. I am not doing enough damage right now, my friends. It's okay, though. We're doing enough damage to survive this room. These dudes slap you, like those things in Banjo-Kazooie and the Clanker's Cavern. Also should be pressing spacebar item once per room. I understand that small rock would be so good if you'd pay out for me right here, baby. You didn't. But Cricket's Head would have also been good, but I didn't say it beforehand, so, you know, I just... Not that it would have mattered anyway. It was all preceded, but the only thing else that was preceded... Your mother! Okay, press this. Oh, we got shots coming out. And we just got a bunch of flies from in here. And a bunch of money in here. So the money's getting a little insane. We definitely have a plenty of rooms that we could come back to and pick up HP from. But honestly, there's probably more rooms than damage can be done. Walnut? Can it pay out with a trinket? I don't think it pays out with trinket. I think it just pays out with consumables. So to me, that's probably not worth it. This room's nothing. Except for all of the items were replaced with rocks and spikes. It's like a Toby Flenderson going away present. That's messed up, man. Okay. Finish him. Finish him. Like a RKO out of nowhere. Get him done. I think I'm probably Isaac's Heart. Tempting maybe, but also not at all. The tiers stat needs to increase. We need a tiers upgrade on this floor, I think. We also need to make sure we're not getting hit, because I would love to maintain this deal with the devil chance. Let's skip like half this floor by going... Hey, get away, man. Let's skip like half this floor by just going right to the boss fight, which is really nice. And then with our Alga's Rune, we can probably guarantee ourselves a deal with the Double. All right, play smart, let these things all go by, and then get it. No tinted rocks in this room. Boss fight incoming. What do we got here? Another Hagalaz, might as well. It's a bunch of pennies. And then I think we go for it. With the Alga's Rune in hand, Teratoma fight is not so bad. It's not so bad. We probably don't even need to use the Alga's Rune. I would prefer not to, but I'm scared, so I'm going to chicken out. And guarantee ourselves a 75% chance to deal with the devil. It's not a guarantee, but it's a pretty good chance. Make it happen. It is a deal with the devil, and we have an HP upgrade out here. So if it's a single deal with the devil, which they are single hearts. Okay. Let's go through my thought process here. Unless we make it to Hush in 10 seconds anyway, we're not going to make it, so speed doesn't matter. Freaking empty void, or whatever it's called, the item on the left, doesn't do anything for us. We will never be with this character in a situation where we have zero HP, unless the coins don't count as HP, but I think they do. So we'll never be on a Spirit Heart or Black Heart build, so that is useless. Contract from below, also kind of useless, honestly. It could give us HP payouts after, but our luck stat's negative 2, so I'm not expecting a ton of payouts anyway. I think what you do is pick up Polydactyl, which I never thought I would say, and we could now potentially, if Runebag wants to pay out for us and just be the greatest man alive, we could technically hold 2 Alga's Runes at any given time. Which I think is what we want to do. So I think we want to try to go on these floors and stack up some Alga's Runes. Scarred Womb with 2 giant rooms right off the bat. Oh, 3 giant rooms right off the bat. Pretty much exactly what you're looking for. Minor heart attack for a second. I thought the entire run was done after all of that BS that I just started spouting. I thought it was for nothing. But the BS is never for nothing. It was just... It just tried to spook me a little bit. It worked. I'll give it to him. I was pretty spooked. Looking for tinted rocks. Should probably focus on the enemies first. Get rid of the enemies and then look for the tinted rocks, you ding dong. Okay. Looking for tinted rocks. I see none. I see none. I see none. Still no small rock. But the hunt continues. But the hunt continues. Thank goodness these guys are not faster, because that would be unfortunate. 12% deal with the double chance now. That is pretty bad, and probably very unlikely that we get one. So I'll just accept that. We could still get that 50-50 deal with the angel chance, though. Should I turn? It's a one bomb gain. It's a trade that makes complete and utter sense. I would understand if you want me to do it. I'm not going to, though, because I am lazy. I see you. Okay. You just play their game. We're going to play their game. Okay. I'm seeing these little spots appear all over the place. I'm not digging it. But I'm going to keep playing this game. Eventually, like, we're hitting him like one shot every 100 years. So eventually, we're going to get it done. There we go. GB Bug almost intercepted him there. Like an Aaron Rodgers pass in the postseason. I'm sorry to my brother. I know he wanted them to win. I'm sorry. Oh, great. Oh, awesome. Yeah. Pick that up. Do you do the mom's hard fight without an Alga's rune? I don't think you do. I think I have to explore some more rooms. Knowing full and well that a room like this could appear, and we could probably just die. However, I also know that we're the most skilled players of all time, and so therefore the chances of us dying are zero. Keep it going. We can also hold Ansu's runes for the next floor, which is really nice as well. Okay, almost there. Got it done. I'm gonna hope and pray that this is a secret room. Can it even be? It could be. Please let me get into my curse room for free. I could also go in the curse room with the 75% chance that we do get a payout, but it just doesn't seem worth it. And now that I'm seeing this, our secret room is actually probably to my left there. And there it has been discovered. Battery charge not super fantastic. What do we even get from there? Just a fly or something? Again, when you're spawning rooms like this, I can't really. Seems kind of dastardly and awful. Double key room, I would so reroll right now. You have no idea how quickly I would reroll. Algis, Ansu's. Oh, you just don't let me. You just don't let me, though. Cricket's head. Oh, Samson's lock. Okay. What do we want to do here? I think I'll just try to fight the mom's heart fight. And we're just hoping that right as I get in there, that we get a nice little payout, maybe even a double payout from Wooden Nickel. I will look for a second secret room. I have been foiled. Of course. Now, it's not completely like, we shouldn't be like, oh, it's over. Because if we take a hit, which I think we might, we can still get a payout, or we get a Nun's Habit charge. Guardian Angel, I'm hoping you're going to block a lot of shots for me here, buddy. I need you now. That's a song that used to be pretty famous, right? I think it did maybe save us from a hit there. Keep it going. Throw some bombs in if you need to. Those are extra damage. Keep it going. Come on. Teratoma, vastly unnecessary. I did not want to see you at all. We are not... I would not even add you on Facebook as a friend. Okay. Throw another bomb in. Okay. Don't like this attack. GB Bug, you keep your thing going. We're going to continue running around here. Okay. Doing some damage. Get ready for the Brimstone attack. Ah! Pick it up. We're fine. Brimstone coming this way. It's coming this way. You got nothing. Give me a void fight. Give me a void portal. Would I go there right away? We don't have the chance. Okay. Going up. There's still possibility here. And at the very least, this is a pretty dang good keeper run. Okay. Pop the Ansu's rune. Know where you're going. And now start making your way to your boss fight. Oh, God. Why? Nickel's good. Got to focus on one of them at a time. I don't know how you just got burned. How to get burned. all that jazz? Focus on one at a time? You're not allowing me to focus on one at a time. No! I did not want the fishula to be unleashed. Did I take a hit? I can't tell. I can't see my HP. I can't tell if we took a hit there. We may have. Pick it up just to be safe. Definitely took a hit there, and I don't know how that money just appeared, but I'm happy that it did because it's guaranteed HP. Okay. If all the rooms are gonna be like this, I think we're effed, but maybe not. Maybe not. A battery charge. We're still looking for Small Rock, by the way. The only damage upgrades we received have been the double pentagram plays. The double pentagram plays paid out. That has literally been our only form of HP of damage upgrade. Which, again, as this character, I shouldn't have picked that up, but I think we're fine. As this character, damage upgrades are literally and figuratively your only way to make sure you can stay ahead of the rooms. But I don't need them anyway. Damage upgrades? I've never had a damage upgrade since I was 2 years old and I had to walk to school both ways in the snow, up a hill, and up a hill both ways as well. And also, you wanna back off, man? We're doing good, we're doing fine. 7.74 damage, not bad. For like the third floor. But for here, we're still killing things relatively quickly. I think it's mostly just this tier stat that's bugging me a little bit. Maybe I would like that to be a little bit higher. Can you take my tier stat higher? Algis ruins the wind to a place with golden streets. Can you take my damage higher, please? I need DPS. We'll then beat Mr. Isaac. Please stand back. Okay. Still got this. Double room. It's not a bad double room. Of all the double rooms we could have gotten, this one's not bad. This one's pretty... Oh, I almost took a hit, so that's how easy it is. This one's pretty not bad. Alga's rune during the Isaac's fight is also fantastic. So many pills. This one's also not that bad. Double Duke of Flies, he's weak. Weak sauce. We even killed one before the other one could even come into my eyesight. Come into my eyesight. Let's not think about any other implications of that. All right, this room's done. One more room before the Isaac fight. Oh, double Loki. Again, double Loki's not bad. But you gotta get a hold. You gotta keep them separated. No, you cannot let this many bomb flies run wild. Run wild, live free, love strong. Please stop spawning bomb flies. Could really use a wish right now. What? Anybody else see that Penny just transform into a bomb? I'm not a magician, but I just saw some David Blaine-esque shiza happen. Oh, let me just scratch my head vigorously. Oh. All right. Now or never. Two Pennies spawn. That is fan-freaking-tastic. Especially when I pick them both up like a moron. Okay, another Penny spawned. Another Penny spawned. Another Penny spawn. And no permanent Polaroid invincibility. No Polaroid invincibility makes it really unfortunate. Like everything. Good start. I just got too scared there. I'm sorry. No, I used the Algus Rune. Ah, da, 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 da. Come on. Get him. Cut him up. There we go. Disnemoration coming in clutch there. We still got some Algus Rune to go, though. Keep going, Algus Rune. It's almost done. It's got to be getting close. And he is way too... Yes. Yes. Yes, we did. Okay. Please, no Curse of the Unknown. Please, that's all I'm asking. I'll take Curse of the Blind over this. Okay, no curses, even better. Amazing items. It's good. It's bad. It's bad. It's okay. I wonder if our luck stat also affects whether or not the void is going to spawn. Okay. We're going to have some tough rooms to deal with on the course of this floor. But 9-volt car battery, Nun's Habit, we have plenty of ways to spawn HP within the room and a battery charge. Again, another Ansu's rune here would be wonderfully delectable. My main thing I'm scared about now is, can we get to some of the HP that we drop on the ground? Because some of it's going to spawn, like, we're going to spawn at the beginning, and we're going to have to dodge throughout the room. The question is, can you get back to your safety? And sometimes the answer to that question is going to be no. Come on, something great. Something great, Mr. Mega. Bomb and a key. Secret room here, perhaps? Secret room here, perhaps? No. Frank and Guggen, no biggie. No biggie at all. You could spawn any of these guys that you want. And now you're just going to spawn obnoxious. Oh, no. That's bullcrap. You can't spawn on top of me. Again, we're just spawning so much HP in the room. We got no problem. We've got no problem. I do not want to do the big room. So I'm going to... Actually, the big room could... the big room could contain death, but it also could contain... Yeah, this is not the room I wanted. If we're being honest with ourselves, I was really hoping for the room with Ultra Pride. Ultra Pride would then pay out with 9 lives. Even though we'd only be one hit away from death at all times, we would have 9 freaking lives. That's what I was looking for. That's what I was looking for in that situation. And you didn't provide, but it's okay. We can't all be the breadwinners. But I'm about to win this bread run. And again, this could all be for nothing. We could beat Blue Baby and a void portal could not show up. It's just, it's random chance. It's probability. It's probability. And a void portal could not show up. But hey, at the very least, we got a win with the keeper. And we could feel pretty proud about that. And maybe we'll come back and try to get the void run again. Again, I think this was mostly just for fun. Just because I was feeling kind of sick. And now I'm feeling a little bit better. This was mostly just a joke. Man, that Yaru would have been cool at the beginning of the floor. This was all mostly just a joke. To be like, hey, I'm feeling better, let's do something stupid. And I hope you guys had a good time with it nonetheless, even though we may or may not even fill out anything on the post-it note from it. Maybe I should stick to greedier mode, because then we can get guaranteed payouts. Maybe, I don't know. This double little horn room is much more obnoxious than I expected it would be. Like, really, really obnoxious. Please step away. Please step away. Blow them up, yes. One has been taken care of. The second has been taken care of. You did not get that bomb off, my friend. Keep searching. Never quit exploring. Oh, Ragman, never quit existing. Look at the curve on that shot. You kidding me? It's insane. So I think if we're like, let's look at probability. If we're saying, and I think it's true, a 75% chance that we spawn a tier... Ooh, Guardian Angel, I think, saved us. There's a 75% chance that our double car battery payouts give us at least one coin. With that in mind, two of those payouts not happening, it has to be something like 90% chance that we use it twice and neither pay out with what we're looking for. It has to be like it's gotta be like literally 90 something percent. Again, these bombs could stop. These bombs are really just unnecessary. There you go. Go to the other side of the room. You're getting a little too close for comfort. Freeze him. Freeze him. Again, just stay over there. As long as we're on this plane, no, too close, man. You do not need to patrol this area. This is not your designated sector. We could get like double Mr. Mega, or probably just some bombs from this guy. Should avoid skinny rooms at all costs, just some bombs. This little keeper head's nothing. Looking for a chest payout so that I can use Yara Root on it and turn one chest into two chests, but again, our luck stat is so bad that the odds of that happening are just slim to none. Are just slim shady to none. But it could still happen. It could still happen. I'm at least proud that we've gotten this far. Again, I should be popping that at the beginning of a room, because otherwise the Nun's Habit charge is wasted. Stop! Don't get lost in your commentary. Oh, please freeze him. Freeze him. Yes. Diss and admiration, do it. Do it. Do it to it. Got it. Double Yera, all the way across the sky. Wow, wow, so intense. Double rainbow on the way. So that side of the floor was a complete waste. I'm almost wondering if we should just give up. No, just kidding. I'm wondering if we should just... Oh, God, he almost hit me. I'm wondering... You're on my coin, man. You're on my coin, man. Again, when you're doing this little damage to Polycephalus, you can't feel great about your odds, but somehow I do. Somehow I feel pretty decent about our chances here. I just need... If the luck stat wasn't negative 2, and we could get a single chest payout, that would be so unbelievably wonderful. A single chest payout could turn into 4 chests, which is basically like a whole... Oh, God. Which is basically like another chest all over again. Again, I'm forgetting repeatedly to use our item, our space bar item, as soon as we get in the room. And so if we lose, it's my fault. I think I have to take this. There's no rocks, and it's going to give us... Okay, now you run this interesting... I wish that was dim light bulb, honestly. I wish you were dim light bulb. We now have this interesting... Well, now we don't, but we have this interesting conundrum, if you will, where I have to decide, is it better to... How do I word this? Is it better to keep the full charge, have the increased tier stat, the increased damage, the increased luck stat, or is it better to have the safety of having a penny on the floor instantly? Because if we take a hit, then our charge is already full, so the nun's habit is a waste. And then if we click spacebar, and it doesn't pay out, we're just effed. We'll do this L-shaped room. I hate L-shaped room. Oh, no, no, I think this might be death. Yeah, I gotta do that. Oh, no, I hate the fallen. Please freeze him. Please freeze him. I need it done. I'm almost tempted to even, like, Yera the, Come at me, bro. There you go. It's fine. He's had, like, a little, like, delay on his shots sometime, and I can't say I'm into it. I don't know how he didn't take a hit there. I do not know how I did not take a hit there. One dead. Get it done. Two's almost dead. You just wrecked little Loki for me. Thank you. Perth row. We can use it on the items up here that we didn't want. Excuse me. I want Vibrant Bulb. Yeah, we can use Perth row up here. Please, please, please. Taurus is invincibility, but I don't think I can stomach the speed downgrade. I do not think it is stomachable. And once again, we've chosen a complete wrong dead end. 50-minute run, guys. Plus, you almost forget that we did one earlier than this, too. Kidney Stone could be good for the initial burst. I think I should probably pick up Kidney Stone. I don't think Kidney Stone is a bad item. I'm basically just holding out in case we get another Perthrow rune. Okay, a little scary there. I'm trying to keep this negative one luck stat. I don't know if you can even get chest spawns with negative one luck. Like, does negative luck mean you're just extra effed? We're getting payouts of some sort. Another Perthrow, so I'm glad I kept this going. Oh, Shrink Shot and Keybum. Rune Bag, if you just want to keep doing your thing. I think I have to pop a thing down here because, yeah, this fight's just too hard. Oh, we didn't get a payout the second time. Brownie fight is too hard. Brownie fight is really freaking hard. Come on. Get it going. Freeze him. Yes, that's what I'm looking for. Get some freezy effects. There we go. This version's not that bad. Get him. No issues. Again, just a single chest. We could turn into 4 chests. A room like this, I don't think we need to worry about using Vibrant Bulb, but if it's a room that's scary, or using our Space Bright, I think we're better off keeping the Vibrant Bulb effect. Just kidding, we'll just take a hit. But luckily we're getting the payouts. We are getting the payouts. We're not getting the chest payouts, but we're getting some payouts anyway. Okay, Gertie fights, no biggie, get in there, keep your Vibrant Bulb, keep that negative one luck. Negative one luck is better than negative two luck, like, statistically, like, objectively, I should say. It is. Bloody Penny, not really what I'm looking for. Boss fight. I'm like a little upset that we still have not managed to find a single chest. Maybe I should look for secret rooms. It's also kind of sucks we don't have a Yara rune for this boss fight. Like, this boss fight's gonna be difficult, do not get me wrong. And so having, please stop spawning little mini monstros. August. Oh, Perthro, again. Let's do it. Let's look for secret rooms as we're going, because a secret room could, oh. Could contain super green. I mean, it could contain super green. Let's be honest, it did. Chest. Ugh, quarter. Pepper tier is good. The flush, I don't think, is good. Where's my other Yara rune? Oh, now we have the question. Do you continue exploring? Which I'm doing right now, so I think you know my answer. The question is, do you continue exploring and look for a chest payout? Look for that chest payout slash the Alga's rune. And I did it, so that is my answer. Alga's rune, pretty much guaranteed blue baby win with our orbitals, I think. Probably makes it pretty easy. And the chest payout would be 4 chests, and therefore we would get 4 more items, which would also just be epic. But it's just not gonna let me get it. Looking for second secret room now. The bombs are also nice. The problem is if we run into like a double adversary room, I think we're just like dead. And again, this was probably not a room that I needed to use. Oh, maybe it was. It's not a room that I needed to use my charge on. Chest, please. We're getting payouts. It's just not the payouts that we need or the ones that we deserve. Double Ragman's no biggie. He's also no biggie, so like be wary of that. Oh, get the flame in there. Yes, Ghost Pepper tears. You guys ever eaten a Ghost Pepper? I've eaten a Carolina Reaper. Ghost Pepper got nothing on that. That burned my butthole for a week. Okay. I think we have this. I'm confident. Are you confident in my blue baby skills? Blank rune. We have to take it? With the hope that it's Alga's. We have to take it with the hope that it's Alga's rune. It is! It is Alga's rune! Get in there! Get in there with Guardian Angel. Get in there with Guardian Angel. Do it. Just tear him to shreds. Guardian Angel is rotating too fast for me to even handle. Oh my god, please spawn a void. Please spawn the void. Please spawn the void. It didn't. All of that for literally nothing. Wow. You ever heard of the term like a Pyrrhic victory? Is that the term for it? Where it's like, yeah, I won, but was it really worth it? Did I actually gain anything from the last hour and 8 minutes? The answer's probably no. Oh, there's the double adversary room. Great. Basically why I came in here was to die. No. Basically the only reason I came in here was to try and get a chest, turn the chest into 4 chests, and hope that one of said chests contains Dad's key. And then we can fight Mega Satan, which has a 50% chance of paying out with the Void fight. That is literally the only thing we can do left. That's the only thing that we can do still. Man. The Alga's rune play on the blank rune was so exciting for nothing. Chest. You son of a bug. I think that's it. We can look for second secret rooms. We have plenty of bombs to do so. So we can look for those. But if we don't find a second secret room, then it's over. Okay, none in this room. That's cool. Can't be in this room. Come on. Isaac Gods, if you are a benevolent force out there, hook me up with Dad's Key. Hook me up with Dad's Key. Now, I could have earlier fought the two angel statues, and we could have gotten the two key pieces from that in our angel room, but I was honestly too scared we would die. I think we probably would have died. Can't be in this room. Could be at the end of this room. Can't be the right. Could be to the up or to the left. Okay, there it is. Chests. It's gonna happen. Is there any possible way? If it's a deal with the angel, it's a 50-50 chance. But we can only get one key piece. It is a deal with the angel. Oh, what a funny time. What a funny, funny time. Is there anything we can do to make a second one spawn? I think that's it. Our literal only chance. This used to be a thing. Sometimes if you went into a deal with the angel and you went right back in, like with Goathead, sometimes a second angel statue would spawn. So our only chance is that this pill right here is telepills, teleports me to the deal with the angel. It's relax. That was the only chance. So, unfortunately, can I get a void to spawn by doing this enough times? I thought maybe we did it. I thought we did it again. Yera. We won as the keeper, but it doesn't matter. It's pointless. Oh, that was a good run nonetheless. We lost the first one. We won the second one, but we didn't get anything done on the post-it note. So literal waste of time, but a good way to come back after I'm feeling a little, was feeling sick. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, make sure you subscribe to become a citizen of Playcrastination today. And if you know anybody that you think would be, let's show the second seed. Shoot. If you know anybody that you think would be a great Playcrastinator, go ahead and send them on by because we'd love to have them. But with that, thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you guys next time.